We are in a chapter called acids, bases and salts. I already told in the previous classes, this is one of the nicest chapter. And this chapter is very important for the public examination to score 6 marks. But the problem of this particular chapter is so many content is given. Therefore, you have to focus your attention to understand each and every concept what is given in the textbook. The concept runs like this. The chemical substances what we see around us are classified as acidic substances, basic substances and neutral substances. To identify these acidic, basic and neutral substances, we use indicators. Indicators are those chemical substances, they help us to understand, determine acidic and basic chemical substances. The one such indicator is called the natural indicator. Examples are litmus and turmeric. This natural indicator, they change their color in acidic and basic medium, and we can able to distinguish between acidic and basic medium. The one more type of indicator is called the olfactory indicator. Olfactory indicator, they change their odor, like onion, clove and vanilla. They change their odor by which we can understand acidic and basic medium. But in the industry, we use synthetic indicators like methyl orange and phenolphthalene. Methyl orange and phenolphthalene are synthetic or a chemical indicator. They change their colors in acidic and basic medium. We know which are the colors we get in acidic and basic medium. Regarding the properties of acids and bases, general properties of acids and bases, acids are sour in taste, bases are bitter in taste. Acids, they turn blue litmus into red, whereas bases, they turn red litmus into blue. These two content you have to remember always. Whenever they ask you to about write the properties of acids, means you have to write these two. Acids are sour in taste, acids they turn blue litmus into red. Bases are bitter in taste, bases turn red litmus into blue. Then what I told you is, all acids are soluble in water, but all bases are not soluble in water. But there are certain bases, they are soluble in water, they are called alkalis. The three major acids you have to remember, always remember, is one is hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid and nitric acid, and their molecular formula HCl, H2SO4, HNO3. You have to remember this. The next is regarding the base. Again, the base, we have one more category called alkali. Alkalis are water soluble bases. Sodium hydroxide, NaOH. Potassium hydroxide, KOH. All bases have OH ion, in OH ion or OH radical in common. In all acids, we can see hydrogen in common. Then we come to the chemical properties of acids and bases. What happens when these acids and bases are added to metal, or metal, how the metals react with acids and bases? To understand this property, we should recall the information what we studied in 8th and 9th standard. First thing is, we should know what are metals, what are non-metals, and atomic number, everything we should know, then only we can progress. In this case, what they are telling is, metals displace hydrogen ion or hydrogen atom or hydrogen gas from dilute acids. Basic statement. Metals displace hydrogen from dilute acid. The experiment, what is given is zinc. Zinc is a metal. When zinc is added to dilute sulfuric acid, the molecular formula of dilute sulfuric acid is H2SO4. That H2 is replaced by Zn. Therefore, the product becomes ZnSO4 plus that H2 is displaced. The hydrogen gas is displaced. And we understood this particular reaction by performing an experiment. The performance of experiment is not required for your examination. Only for the interest sake, I conducted the experiment. 10th standard, there is no practicals. The 10th standard, there is no experimentation. Only thing is, you have to understand the higher classes, particularly in PUC classes, you are going to do these experiments, right? And try to understand. That particular equation, Zn plus H2SO4 give rise to ZnSO4 plus H2. Hydrogen gas is released. How to check the presence of the hydrogen gas? The hydrogen gas can be checked with the help of popping sound experiment or combustible test. Hydrogen is highly combustible gas. That you have to remember, hydrogen is the lightest element. All stars are made up of hydrogen, because you have a chapter called sources of energy. In that they ask, how sun is producing energy? Sun is producing energy by a process called thermonuclear fusion. There hydrogen fuses to form helium. That you are going to learn in the last chapter of physics. Forget about that, but try to understand. And hydrogen is a gas, it's a combustible gas. Its atomic number is 1, atomic mass number is also 1. And this particular hydrogen we can check by combustible, highly combustible gas it is, right? That part I did. The next part is the base. When you consider a base, what happens when a metal is added to a base? Here we should be very careful. All bases we can't use. We can use a base which is soluble in water. If it is a soluble in water, we should call it as what? If a base is soluble in water, we call it as what? We call it as alkali. The best alkali is sodium hydroxide. For sodium hydroxide, if you add a zinc, what happens? You get a compound called sodium zincate, Na2ZnO2, plus hydrogen gas is released. Therefore, we can generalize this. Metals can able to displace hydrogen gas from dilute acids. Adding some alkalis, it can able to displace hydrogen gas, right? The metal what the textbook is selected is zinc. Now, the next part, the next unit is carbonates. You know, carbonates means, you have to remember, CO3. CO3 is carbonate. Calcium carbonate, CaCO3. Sodium carbonate, Na2CO3. Carbonates means CO3 is there. Two carbonates that are selected in the textbook. One is sodium carbonate. Another one is sodium hydrogen carbonate. These two are the examples for metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate. Na2CO3, that is washing soda. NaHCO3, that is baking soda. When acid is added to these carbonates, carbon dioxide is really simple question. Which name the gas that releases when an acid is added, when a dilute acid is added to carbonates? Name suggests carbonates. Which gas? Carbon dioxide. Carbonates, carbon dioxide. Equation, you have to practice that equation. Na2CO3 plus HCl. That the acid is HCl. We get NaCl plus H2O plus CO2. Carbon dioxide. Now the next question arises. Hydrogen we checked. Hydrogen gas is checked by popping sound experiment or combustible test. Then how to check the presence of carbon dioxide? What we have to do is allow the carbon dioxide to pass through lime water. Lime water turns milky because of the formation of white precipitate of calcium carbonate. That equation also you have to remember, because that equation is going to repeat once again. And by that we can able to understand this particular gas is carbon dioxide. This are all I completed in the previous class. In every class, why I repeat all these things? We should recall what we studied. Recalling technique is the one of the best technique of learning. Simply seeing and video or reading a book is no use. After closing the books, you should able to understand, recall what all you studied. Then only you, that is becomes the concretization. The information settles in the brain, right? We have both conscious brain and subconscious brain. In the conscious brain we see. After seeing, then we have to recall. When we recall what all we have seen in the conscious brain, it goes and settles in the subconscious brain. To settle in the subconscious brain, we have to wait, we have to give time. Again and again we have to remember things, then only it settles in the conscious brain, subconscious brain. Once it stays in the subconscious brain, it becomes a permanent memory. Therefore, whenever you see like this, it is all conscious brain. You forget. But after that, close your eyes and recall what you studied. Then gradually it becomes a permanent memory. Once it becomes a permanent memory, that information can be used whenever it is required. That you have to remember always. Therefore, learning is pleasurable only after learning. Try to understand. You see a video, you return the notes, you have written this assignment, everything is over. Keep aside. Then recall what I studied. Recall all, every information you recall. When you recall every information, again that picture comes out. Again that information comes out. And that time it remains, it goes to the subconscious brain. Subconscious brain is a bigger part than the conscious brain. In computer language we can tell this as ROM and RAM. RAM is conscious, ROM is permanent, disk, memory, right? That you have to understand, right? Now see, today's part is what? I am in the fourth unit now. First unit is indicators, second unit is acids and metals, third unit is regarding carbonates and acids, fourth unit is what happens when these acids and bases, they react themselves. If you take an acid, if you take a base and mix them, what happens? Because they both of them having entirely different properties, as the property of acid is entirely different from the property of the base. They are opposite in nature. If you make them to react, what happens? Now, reaction of acids and bases. This also you have studied. Reaction of acids and bases. See children. Acid. I take an acid, that is hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid, the molecular formula is HCl. I select a base, the best base always, usually we select the best alkali, that is sodium hydroxide. It is a base, it is an acid. Acid, it is. It is a base. But an acid reacts with a base. What happens? If you are aware of the fact, this type of reaction is called double displacement reactions. What happens? Here, when an acid reacts with a base, it going to form a salt. HCl plus NaOH, when they react, the sodium reacts with chlorine to form NaCl. NaCl, that is salt. Plus, and this hydrogen reacts with OH of the base. Hydrogen on the acid reacts with OH of the base to form water. To form water. Therefore, when an acid reacts with a base, when an acid reacts with a base, we get salt and water. And an acid reacts with a base, we get salt and water. Such reactions are called neutralization reaction. Neutralization reaction. Such reactions are called neutralization reaction. Neutralize, nullifies the effect. The bases nullify the effect of an acid. Acid nullifies the effect of a base. And when they combine together, the property changes, it becomes neutralized. Try to understand. When we use methyl orange or phenolphthalein, we don't get a color of either orange or yellow or red. We get the middle, neutral. You get a neutral. It is neither acidic nor basic. This is called a neutral salt. You are aware of the concept that NaCl. NaCl is a common salt. The salt what we eat is NaCl, sodium chloride. Sodium chloride is a neutral salt, it is. Therefore, when an acid reacts with a base, the product what we get is called salt and water. Such reactions are called neutralization reaction. Examination, they may ask a question. What is a neutralization reaction? When an acid reacts with a base, it forms, the product formed are salt and water. This type of reactions are called neutralization reaction. Give an example for a neutralization reaction. One equation they are given in the textbook, that is HCl plus NaOH give rise to NaCl plus H2. Very nice students, they can change this acid. You can write H2SO4, you can write HNO3, and you can complete the equation. But I want to insist, because nowadays we are getting students, some of the students, because this year we have not done any entrance examination for admission for 10th standard. Therefore, we are some of the students are, I think, learning wise they are below average. Therefore, I insist only on the textbook content. Textbook content. HCl given in the textbook. NaOH given in the textbook. HCl plus NaOH give rise, which are the salt? NaCl plus H2O. NaCl is a salt. H2O is water. Right? Here you have to understand water. Fantastic. Water is a neutral. Why? Because H2O, if it is split in, if you split that, it becomes H plus OH minus. Means in water, acidic acid is there. OH means base is there. Acid plus base, both mixed, it becomes neutral. Try to understand. When acid plus base, acid neutralizes, nullifies the effect of the base, base nullifies the effect of the acid. Both nullify each other. Therefore, we get a neutral concept. Therefore, water, when you take water, its pH is 7, it is a neutral solution. Why? Because it is having both acidic ion which is present in the acid, that is also there, the ion which is present in the base, that is also there. Therefore, water we always remember as a neutral solution. It is neither acidic nor basic. The whole reaction becomes neutral, neutralization reaction. The same reaction that takes place even when we eat food. See, in our stomach, there is an acid that secretes. The acid secreted in our body, in stomach, is nothing but hydrochloric acid. This hydrochloric acid secrete and started touching the internal lining of the stomach. Therefore, it starts burning. That burning sensation is called hunger. When you feel hungry, you feel some sort of burning sensation. That means to say that hydrochloric acid is secreted and it starts burning. Therefore, nothing is there to eat. What you can do? Take one glass of water and drink. By drinking water, what happens? That acid what is secreted in the stomach is dilutes. By that, the lining becomes safe. Therefore, always it is better to take water in small sips. Why? Because that extra acid what produces in the stomach, that dilutes. Therefore, you are safe. Your intestinal tract or stomach tract is safe. When acid is secreted, that is called the hydrochloric acid, then we have to eat food. The food what we eat is, majority of the food material what we eat are basic in nature. That base neutralizes the acid, and that neutralization takes place in the body, and we get the whole body becomes almost the food neutralizes the acid, and we get salt and water. Understand? Salt and water you get, and you get energy. That is a process. Therefore, while eating, you should not eat. If you eat more food, what happens? The acid secreted in our stomach, that hydrochloric acid, is not sufficient. Therefore, you have to add little more acid to make it digestible. If you eat less food, then the acid is more, food is less. Therefore, that fellow feels acidity. Acidity comes. That's why you have to eat at regular time, they tell. Why we have to eat at regular time? When acid secretes, put food, neutralizes. Neutralization is one such reaction where in which an acid reacts with a base to form salt and water. Therefore, you have to remember this particular statement. What is neutralization reaction? When an acid reacts with a base, it forms salt and water. This type of reaction is called neutralization reaction. Example for that is HCl plus NaOH give rises to NaCl plus H2O. This equation given in the textbook. Suppose you are intelligent, you write, you change the acid. Instead of HCl, write it as H2SO4, then it becomes plus NaOH, it becomes Na2SO4 plus H2. You can write HNO3 plus NaOH give rises to NaNO3 plus H2O. Like that, you can change, but not required for SLC. Not required, but if you are intelligent, you can try and solve. But at that time, you should know how to write the molecular formula. To write the molecular formula, you should understand how to write the electronic configuration, valencies, valence electrons, and how to write the molecular formula. Then only you can write the equation. I think the writing the electronic configuration is a very common thing, very easiest thing that what you studied in 8th and 9th standard. That you know, therefore, remember this equation. Enough. 10th standard, remember this equation. HCl plus NaOH give rises to NaCl plus H2. I already told you, keep a formula book, right? In the mathematics, I told you, keep a formula book. In that formula book, write the chemical equation. Which are the chemical equation we study in 10th standard? So for what, which are the chemical equation you remember? List it out and write it and keep every time you practice that, then you can easily remember the molecular formula and the chemical equation. This is the chemical equation of neutralization. Again, I repeat, HCl plus NaOH. HCl is an acid, NaOH is a base, forms NaCl plus H2. Next unit of this particular chapter is metal oxides. Reaction of metal oxides. Metal oxides with acids. Reaction of metal oxides with acid. To understand this particular unit, you have to remember one thing. Metals. Again, I tell you, metal, what are metals? What are metals? Now you have to tell, because you have studied. What are metals? Metals are electropositive elements. Very simple answer. What are metals? I write it here. It is a revision part. It is metals. Metals are, it is a revision part. It is metals are, what are metals? Metals are electropositive elements. Electropositive elements are called metals. Remember, you are present, you know 20 elements, right? I told you to practice 20 elements. Which are those 20 elements? I write it again here. First one is hydrogen. Second one is helium. Third one is lithium. Fourth one is beryllium. Fifth one is boron. Sixth one is carbon. Seventh one is nitrogen. Eighth one is oxygen. Ninth one is fluorine. Tenth one is neon. You have to remember this. I told you. Prepare. Remember. Practice this. 11th one is sodium. 12th one is magnesium. 13th one is aluminium. 14th one is silicon. 15th one phosphorus. 16 is sulfur. 17 is chlorine. 18 is argon. 19 is potassium. 20 is calcium. Always you have to remember this first 20. When the elements are given, these elements are classified as metals and non-metals. These elements are classified as metals and non-metals. Can you identify metals in this list? Can you able to identify metals in this list? That is the first thing. And those metals, how we are able to understand this? This metal, we have to write the electronic configuration by keeping their atomic number. That all thing you studied in the previous class. Using atomic number, you have to write electronic configuration. After writing electronic configuration, you have to write the valence electrons. Then you should know what is valency. Then only you have to come to the writing molecular formula. This is, in 10th standard, we are using the molecular formula. In 8th and 9th, we completed this portion, and 10th standard, we are using the molecular formula and write the chemical equations. Right? Now see, forget about our previous learning. Now identify some of the metals in this group, in this list. Which is a metal? I tell you, lithium is a metal. Beryllium is a metal, boron is a metal, and after that these are all non-metals. Nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, carbon, they are all non-metals. This is non-metal. They are all non-metals. Again metal comes. Sodium is a metal, magnesium is a metal, aluminium is a metal, silicon is a non-metal. Non-metal, 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 again metal. Potassium is a metal, calcium is a metal. And all these metals are, when you write the electronic configuration and write the valency, you can understand all these metals are electropositive in nature. Metals are electropositive in nature. Whereas, non-metals, if metals are electropositive, what is non-metals? Non-metals are electronegative in nature. Non-metals are electronegative elements. Therefore, in the periodic table, we have electropositive elements and electronegative elements. And these electropositive elements and electronegative elements, they combine together to form plus, reacts with minus to form a compound. Very simple it is. But it is simple. But for this, you have to write electronic configuration and valency, valence electrons, and write the molecular formula. Then we can easily understand 10th standard equation. But since we are in online class, even in regular class also, you have to understand this writing of electronic configuration. I make one video of electronic configuration of 8th and 9th standard after this class. Then you see and try to understand. Right? Now see, I come back to my 10th standard syllabus. What is asking is reaction of metal oxides with acid. We all know that metal oxides are, metals are electropositive in nature. This metal oxides are basic in nature. These metal oxides are basic in nature. How to check? How to check metal oxides are basic in nature? That part is there in the 10th standard. This are all part is already you studied. Now we are going to study metal oxides are basic in nature. Right? For that one, he made an experiment. The experiment is like this. What he is telling is, take copper oxide. Copper, again, it is called the cupric oxide. Take copper oxide, add hydrochloric acid, dilute hydrochloric acid, HCl. He is not given the equation, I am writing the equation. Take copper oxide, cupric oxide, add dilute hydrochloric acid. When you add dilute hydrochloric acid, the solution, copper oxide is there, you are adding hydrochloric acid, dilute hydrochloric acid, and start stirring. Suddenly, you can see the change of color in the solution. The solution becomes blue-green in color. Blue-green in color. The solution becomes blue-green in color. What is the reason for the change of color when we add dilute hydrochloric acid to cupric oxide? That is the question asked. I repeat once again, when dilute hydrochloric acid is added to cupric oxide, solution turns into blue-green in color. What is the reason for this? Which is the chemical is going to form? And by that, what we understand? That is the part we have to learn in this particular unit of 10th standard. The answer is very simple. Cupric oxide
when we add dilute hydrochloric acid, reaction takes place. When the reaction takes place, in that reaction, what we are going to get, this copper is electropositive. Copper is a metal, right? Understand? Copper is electropositive. Chlorine is electronegative. Copper is electropositive, chlorine is always positive attracts the negative. Copper is electropositive, chlorine is electronegative. They combine together to form a compound called cupric chloride, CuCl2. Cupric chloride and water we are going to get. And the color that is going to get, that is blue-green color, is because of the formation of the cupric chloride in the solution. The blue-green color is the color of the cupric chloride. Then what happens? They may ask a question like this. What happens when dilute hydrochloric acid is added to cupric oxide or copper oxide? The solution turns into blue-green in color because of the formation of cupric chloride. Write the chemical equation. It is not given in the textbook. If they give this question, it is an application type of question. Higher order question. It is higher order question. I think, I consider you all people are very brilliant and you are going to face SLC examination. You come out with a very bright colors and you are going to take engineering, medicine or like that type of children only there. I imagine, I assume that. Therefore, I am writing this. Cupric oxide, dilute hydrochloric acid when we add, the solution turns into blue-green color and the blue-green color is the formation of the cupric chloride. Now, you see this equation properly. See this. In this what happened? HCl, hydrochloric acid. Is it an acid or a base? You tell me. Hydrochloric acid is an acid or a base. Obviously, it is an acid. Name suggests it is an acid. Right? Then cupric chloride is a salt because it is having a positive and negative. Positive, electropositive and electronegative. Therefore, it is a salt. This is H2O is water. Now, see. In the previous section, unit, what I told you is, when an acid reacts with a base, we are going to get salt and water. Such reactions are called neutralization reaction. I told you, you are taken down, you are written in the notes. The previous unit, reaction of acids and a base. Acids and bases are then nullify their effect. The reaction of acid reacts with a base to form salt and water. Such reactions are called neutralization reaction. Salt and water is formed. One, this part is called the reactant part and this part is called the product part. This is product and this is the reactant. We put this, we get it. This is input, that is output. Try to understand now. In the output we got salt and water. In the input we put acid. Then the other input, this should be what? I put a question mark here. You have to tell me. Is it an acid or a base? This question mark, in this question mark you have to write now. You have to write, what is this? Since we are getting salt and water and one of the reactant is an acid, therefore definitely cupric oxide is a base. Because we know that when a base reacts with an acid, only we get salt and water. The one of the reactant is an acid. The product what we got is salt and water. Definitely, the one of the reactant, the other reactant in the reaction is a base. Therefore, we can conclude that this is a metal oxide. Metal oxides are basic in nature. This experiment verifies that metal oxides are basic in nature. Therefore, what type of question we can guess in this type of unit is, with an equation, with the help of an equation, show that metal oxides are basic in nature. The answer is very simple. When an acid reacts with a base, we get salt and water. such reactions are called neutralization reaction. Now write the equation CuO plus HCl give rises to CuCl2 plus H2. In this reaction, the products are salt and water. One of the reactant is an acid, therefore the other reactant should be a base. That verifies that copper oxide is a base. Copper oxide is a base. What is copper? Copper is a metal. Therefore, metal oxides are basic in nature. That particular content is verified by this particular equation. I repeat once again. Copper oxide is there. We have to add dilute hydrochloric acid. How we can understand reaction is taking place or not? When copper oxide add hydrochloric acid, how we can understand chemical reaction is taking place or not? By the change of color. The color of the solution start changing into blue-green in color. This blue-green color is the color of cupric chloride. That verifies that reaction is taking place. Try to understand. See, children, understand this. When a material is there, add one more material. We can't confirm that reaction is taking place or not. We can't confirm. How we can say that the reaction is taking place or not? If there is a change in color, if there is a change of odor, if there is a change in temperature, if there is a change of state, then we can understand, oh, there is something is happening here. Understand? There is a material, add one more material, nothing, no change of temperature, no change of color, no change of state, no change of smell, nothing is there. Then we say that, oh, these two compounds are non-reacting compounds. Suppose, take a compound, add one more compound. Some heat is released, reaction is taking place. Color is changed, reaction is taking place. Some amount of smell, different type of smell is coming, reaction is taking place. Suddenly solid become liquid, liquid become gas, state of change. Then we can say that something is happening there. The same way, when we add dilute hydrochloric acid to copper oxide, what change we can able to see? Change of color. The color turns into blue. The solution becomes what? The hydrochloric acid is colorless, it becomes blue-green. When it becomes blue-green, we understand, oh, reaction is taking place. Why it becomes blue-green? Blue-green color is the color of copper chloride. And along with that, water is the solution it is. Therefore, when dilute hydrochloric acid is added to copper oxide, the solution turns into blue-green in color because of the formation of CuCl2 plus H2. Therefore, when we write the equation, in this reaction equation, this is salt, this is water, this is an acid. Then what is this? This should be a base. Then what it is? It is a metal oxide. Therefore, metal oxides are basic in nature. That we can confirm in this particular equation. Therefore, our conclusion is what? Reaction of metal oxides with acid. Metal oxides are basic in nature. They react with acid to form salt and water. Metal oxides are what nature? Basic. They react with what? Acid to form what? Salt and water. And this is also an example for neutralization reaction. Next unit of this particular lesson is reaction of non-metallic oxides with bases. The previous section was reaction of metallic oxides with acids. Now we are talking about reaction of non-metallic oxides with bases. Again, we have to go to our previous class and understand this. Again, you see this. What I told you is, metals are electropositive elements. We know elements up to 20. Out of these 20 elements, we are able to understand which are the metals. Metals, we can easily understand lithium is a metal, lightest metal it is. Lithium, beryllium, boron, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, potassium, calcium, they are all metals. Then what is the rest of the elements? Then what about this? Hydrogen is a non-metal.
helium is a non-metal, carbon is a non-metal, they are all non-metals.
These non-metals are electronegative elements. Therefore, elements are classified either classified as metals or non-metals. That you understood in the previous class. In 10th standard, we are going to learn one more thing. Metals, elements are classified as metals and non-metals. That is, electropositive and electronegative. There are certain elements, they exhibit both the properties of metals and non-metals. They are called metalloids. And that we are going to learn in the chapter called Metals of 10th Standard. But electropositive, electronegative, we already studied this. All you have studied. Now, what I told you is, metals are electropositive elements. Non-metals are electronegative elements, right? Metals are electropositive, non-metals are electronegative. Metals, metal oxides. So for what we did is, metal oxides are basic in nature. Metal oxides are basic in nature, therefore they react with an acid to form salt and water. Therefore, what about non-metallic oxides? Non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. Metal oxides are basic in nature, non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. This now we are going to verify. This is we studied. Now we are verifying in 10th standard. Now 10th standard content. This is the lower class. Now 10th standard. Reaction of non-metallic oxides with bases. Easiest equation, already you learned this equation, they are given in the textbook. That is, see, non-metallic oxides, non-metal means carbon. Carbon is a non-metal. Carbon dioxide is a non-metallic oxide. Carbon dioxide is a non-metallic oxide, right? Carbon is a non-metal oxide. When an element reacts with oxygen, you get oxides. Non-metal reacts with oxygen to form non-metallic oxide, and this is carbon dioxide. Carbon is a non-metal. And then, this non-metallic oxides is going to react with a base. What is common in all base? What is common in all base? In all bases, OH should be there. Therefore, we are making it to react with CaOH whole twice. You are familiarized with this particular compound. Calcium hydroxide, it is called lime water. Sunnada neeru ke calcium hydroxide anta karitare. CaOH whole twice. The previous class I told you, when you paint, when you rub the lime water on the wall, the newly constructed building, they put what is known as lime water. Sunna hoditare. Sunna horadaga nimige adu belli kaanode illa. Yen hodita idane ivanu bellige illa anta anusutte. Adu horadu mele ondu 10 nimisha aadmele onagak start agutte. Aa onaguvaga belli kaanutte. Ashtu devattu belli kaanlilla. Yaar kaanlilla andre ಆ ಸುಣ್ಣದ ನೀರು ಲೈಮ್ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಶಿಯಂ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಅದು ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಗಾಳಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ನ ಹೀರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬೆಳಗಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಹೀರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಕ್ಕೆ ಟೈಮ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಸುಣ್ಣ ಹೊಡಿಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಹೊಡಿತೀವಿ ಮಧ್ಯಾಹ್ನದ ಹೊತ್ತು ಸುಣ್ಣ ಹೊಡಿಬಾರ್ದು ಯಾಕೆ ಒಣಗು ಬೇಗ ಒಣಗೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಇಳಿಯೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಟೈಮ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಲೈಮ್ ವಾಟರ್ CaOH whole twice ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಲೈಮ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಸುಣ್ಣದ ನೀರು ಇನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ CaOH whole twice OH stands for a base OH stands for a base it is therefore no, we don't have any doubt that this is a base or an acid we don't have any doubt this is a base we know that when they react each other why it becomes white because it is going to form a compound called CaCO3 it is white and it is called the salt it is called salt plus we get water this is water now see children again in this reaction
I got salt and water as a product. In the product I got salt and water. This is output, what I get. Then what I put in this, one is base. Then what is this? A question mark is reacts with a base to get salt and water means, anybody can understand, we are already having a statement that acid reacts with the base to form salt and water. Now a question mark is reacting with the base to form salt and water means the question mark should be an acid. Therefore, this is an acid. This should be an acid. By that what we understand, this is an acid. What is this? This is a non-metallic oxide. Therefore, non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. That is confirmed in this particular equation. Then what we cross-check? We are cross-checking the information we already studied in the previous class. In the previous class, we studied that metal oxides are basic in nature. We verified. Non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. We verified with the help of equation. Here, we are verifying that non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. CO2, carbon dioxide, carbon is a non-metal, reacts with oxygen to form carbon dioxide. It is a non-metallic oxide, reacts with a base. How we understood that it is a base? OH is there, it is a base. Reacts to form what? CaCO3, calcium carbonate is a salt. It is a white precipitate, it is insoluble in water and water also. And this equation verifies that non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. Therefore, the examination, they may ask a question. With an example, explain that non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. What you have to write? Carbon dioxide is a non-metallic oxide. When carbon dioxide is made to react with a base called calcium hydroxide, we are going to get salt, that is calcium carbonate and water H2O. The equation is CO2 plus CaOH whole twice give rise to CaCO3 plus H2O. In this reaction, calcium hydroxide is a base, calcium carbonate is a salt, H2O is water, therefore carbon dioxide is an acid. This verifies that non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. This is your very important, it is non-metallic oxide, carbon dioxide, you know the carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is aerated, see, soda water, soda. In water, they put carbon dioxide, aerated drinks, any aerated drinks. You take anything, when you open, you get a fizz. Burugu barate, nore barate. Adalladalli carbon dioxide. Aerated drinks anta karitara nimma Pepsi Gipsy ellu aerated drinks. Ee aerated drinks alli carbon dioxide irutte. Carbon dioxide is acidic basic acidic adrinda ee soda vanna athwa aerated drinks anna naavu bari hottege kudibardu yake ante iga artha agirutte hotteyalli bari hotte andre hydrochloric acid irutte acid irutte soda neeru kudidre aerated drinks kudidre acidic acid hog serkonbuttade ಅದು ಹೊಟ್ಟೆ ಉರಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆ ಸಿಕ್ಕಾಪಟ್ಟೆ ತಿಂದುಬಿಟ್ಟು ತುಂಬ ತಿಂದುಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಯಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡಿಂದ ಅದನ್ನು ಜೀರ್ಣ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ಅಂದಾಗ ಸೋಡಾ ಕುಡಿಬೇಕು ಯಾಕೆ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇದೆ ಬೇಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದೆ ಅವ್ರು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಆ ಬೇಸ್ ಕರಗುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋ ಇದು ನಾಲೆಜನ್ನು ನಾವು ಗೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿಡ್ metallic oxides are basic in nature, non-metallic oxides acidic in nature, that we understood. And these two information what we get with the help of a reaction called neutralization reaction. What is that neutralization reaction? When an acid reacts with a base, it forms salt and water. And metallic oxides are basic in nature, therefore metallic oxide reacts with an acid to form salt and water. Non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature, therefore non-metallic oxide reacts with a base to form salt and water. That we are able to understand. There are in the textbook, they are given certain units related to chemical equation. One is reaction of acids and bases with metals. reaction of acids and bases with metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate. Third one is reaction of metals, acids and bases. Fourth one is reaction of metallic oxides with acids. Fifth one is reaction of non-metallic oxides with bases. Only 5 units are there in this particular unit. 5 units I completed. Once again I repeat, which are the 5 units and which are the equation. When I write the equation, once again I write. What you have to do is, you have to write it down in the notes. And again you have to practice. Here understanding is the thing you understand only by repetition. You have to write it again and again and understand the molecular formula and write the equation, right? Again, I write the chemical equation what I used in this particular chapter. Only 5 units are there. 5 units and few equations. You have to remember those equations. Write it down. Write these equations in your formula book. Whenever you get time, you see that. By that, you can understand the molecular formula and the equation. See, the 5 units are reactions, chemical reactions. 5 units are there. See, first unit, first day, what I told you, experiment also we conducted, that is reaction of metals with acids and bases, here only 2 equations you have to understand. The 2 equations are, one is Zn plus H2SO4, we don't write any dilute or concentrated, write like this. Zn plus H2SO4 give rise to ZnSO4 plus H2. The information is metals displace hydrogen gas from dilute acids. Hydrogen gas is released, put an aqua. The same reaction when we talk about the base, Zn plus NaOH. 10th standard student should understand, OH is there, it is a base, H is there, it is an acid. When zinc and sodium hydroxide reacts, we get a compound called sodium zincate. Sodium zincate means Na2, ZnO2 plus we get hydrogen. Here you have to be very careful, this base is soluble in water, this reaction takes place in water, this is soluble in water. Water soluble bases are called alkalis. These 2 equations I told you I written, and this experiment also we did. Remember this equation, don't write something else. Zn plus H2SO4 give rise to ZnSO4 plus H2. Zn plus NaOH give rise to Na2, ZnO2 plus H2. This is called sodium zincate. Right? The second thing is reaction of acids with metal hydrogen carbonate. More equations are there. Here in this part we write an equation, metal carbonate. First take the metal carbonate is washing soda, that is Na2CO3. Metal hydrogen carbonate, NaHCO3, this is baking soda. One hydrochloric acid, dilute hydrochloric acid is added. When dilute hydrochloric acid is added to these two compounds, we are going to get same result. One is we get a salt, that is sodium hydroxide, sodium chloride, we get water. But we can't call this as a neutralization reaction, because along with that we get carbon dioxide gas we get.
Now the gas obtained is carbon dioxide or not? How to check? For that purpose, we have another two equations. One is take the carbon dioxide, allow it to pass through live water. Live water turns into milky because of the formation of calcium carbonate, and you get water. And if you continue to pass this carbon dioxide to this product, the product is what? The product, I can continue like this only, here only. Equation, see, or I write it again. What is the product? CaCO3 plus H2O. For this one, again you pass carbon dioxide. It again merges together to form calcium bicarbonate. Calcium bicarbonate. It is soluble, it is insoluble. This is the second unit. First unit is reaction of metals with acids and bases. Second one is acids with metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate. Equations, you have to write and practice this. The third one is reaction of acids and bases. Acids and bases. What happens when acids and bases, they react together? When they react together, they nullify the effect. That the type of reaction is called neutralization. Here only I write the equation. That is, very simple equation, HCl plus NaOH. HCl plus NaOH give rise to NaCl plus H2O. In the neutralization reaction, when an acid reacts with a base, we get salt and water. This reaction is called what? Neutralization reaction. Practice this. Neutralization reaction. Acid, base, salt, water. Acid, base, salt, water. Practice. The fourth one is reaction of metal oxide. Metal oxide with metal oxide and acid. Metal oxide and acid. Reaction is very simple. Copper oxide is a metal oxide. Hydrochloric acid is an acid. We get CuCl2 plus water. Here the color, you have to remember the color. The examination they may give color. The color of the cupric chloride is blue-green. Blue-green. What happens when they may ask? When dilute hydrochloric acid is added to copper oxide, what happens? The solution turns into blue-green because of the formation of cupric chloride. Write the equation. CuO plus HCl give rise to CuCl2 plus H2. The next fifth and the last one is non-metal oxides. Non-metal oxides and base. Non-metal oxides and base. Non-metal oxides. Non-metal oxide, same equation. Which equation? This equation is repeated in the textbook once again. Which is that reaction? Carbon dioxide, CO2. Base, CaOH whole twice. It gives rise to what? CaCO3, salt, plus water. How many equations are there in this chapter? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 equations you have to practice. 100% you are going to get one equation for the public exam. 9 equations to practice, you should understand some of the content. Read, see the video once again, make your own notes, and take down the notes given in the every video, end of the video, and remember this. These 9 equations you have to write in your formula book. Every time, if you get time, you have to read H2SO4. How to read this? Don't read Zn plus H2SO4 give rise to ZnSO4 plus H2. Not like that, you have to read. You have to read zinc plus, what is this? Sulfuric acid. Zinc plus sulfuric acid give rise to zinc sulfate plus hydrogen. Like that, you have to read. Reading is with the help of words. Understood? This also. Zinc plus sodium hydroxide give rise to sodium zincate plus hydrogen. This is the way of reading. Write with the molecular formula, write the chemical equation, means you have to write like this.